Pimienta y sal.
Thank you.
Voy un barajo aquí adelante que no me ve.
No, el botaxi es un carro con pegatina, se llama la pegatina, la licencia. Verificativo.
Well, my friends, and now we're gonna cross a tunnel. That tunnel has been made in 1958 by the French company GPM. Compagnie de Grand Travaux de Marseille. My friends, this is the biggest statue of the world made by a woman in Carrara marble, imported from Italy. It was a Cuban artist, Hilma Madera, in 1958, who made that statue of Jesus Christ. Well, just in a second we're gonna get out of the bus and we're gonna start visiting all the bus. Here to your left, just to be the station of a cruise ship. Usually we had three, even four cruise ships at the same time here. But no anymore because of the American government, you know, after Trump finished.
Thank you.
Family. Family. Town. Spanish town.
Jestem w mieście Havana. Tak, na Kubie. Bye, camera, is the best.
And he died in Cuba. You know, Pierre Ramon de Belleville, he was the foundator of the city of Mobile in French Louisiana, United States. It was him. And then he came to visit Cuba and then he got sick. Pierre Ramon de Belleville. Well, that fort, huh? Look at the position, a strategic position at both forts. On both sides of our entrance of the bay. If you pass over here any time at night, 2, 3, 4, 5 in a night, you're gonna see thousands and thousands of people all around the world just talking, fishing, meeting somebody, playing music. It's real life, you know why? It's a warm in Cuba. At night, there are not many places where people can go and have fun. Here, it costs nothing. So some musicians, they come to play guitars here. Then the couples, they meet here. They play the fresh air. Some of them, they come to fish or just talk. They spend good time here the whole night, breathing through fresh air. Here. This seawall has 8 kilometers long. It was made in 5 different periods of times from 1898 to 1950. 8 kilometers of seawall. Yeah. Well, that's what we had. We had that before yesterday, it called front. It's a wind coming from now. But it was very weak. That's why it's not that big the waves. In winter time here, sometimes they close this strip because it's full of water. Then the big waves passing about 10 meters over the wall. Oh, over there, 35 floors is a famous hospital. A lot of foreign people, they are having medical care in there. If one are considered one of the best in Latin America, the hospital Hermanos Almejeira. And now, my friend, you're gonna see the difference. It's finish all the oldest part of the city, beginning here, the modern Havana. The modern Havana is a Havana of 20th century. You know, see some important buildings now. That one, a beautiful architecture, It's a five-star hotel, Hotel Nacional. That one, made in 1930. The blue one at the back is a former Hilton hotel made by the Americans in 1957. But just 2 years later, we had the Cuban Revolution, and the hotel had been nationalized. In this hotel, we had a famous casino before the 59. It was one of the most important in Latin America. The historian says that in Cuba, in Havana, just in Havana, the all the casinos of Havana, just to make more money than the union of all the casinos of the rest of Latin America. You know, we had here famous mafioso, Lucky Luciano, Leto Barletta, Meyer Lansky, Al Capone, all of them living a part of the life here.
Who wants to talk now? Well, my friend, we're going to Revolution Square. This is one of the main streets in Havana, in a modern Havana. It's a 23rd Avenue of Vedado. This is a Vedado neighborhood. We call it a modern Havana because it's a Havana of the 20th century. Here at the colonial time, we had just trees, vegetation. So the buildings, they started making the buildings in 20th century. Well, this avenue is called the Avenue of the Presidents. They just put a poster, a little monument, of all the Cuban presidents. Well, here to the right side, National Theater. And here, Revolution Square. You see, here to the left, the face of Che Guevara, Minister of Interior. The tower, 150 meters high, representing a star going up to the sky. The monument in front of the tower is José Martí, one of the most important personalities in the Cuban history. He was a poet, organizer of a Revolutionary Party of Cuba. Here to the left, Camilo Cienfuegos, general of the was a general in the Revolution of 59. And the building is the Ministry of Communications. Here to the left now, National Library. The next building is a Ministry of the Army. And the building behind the tower in front of us, it's offices where Cuban president work. Offices of a government. And up there, where we have a Cuban flag, Fidel Castro used to talk to the Cuban people. And here in the big square, they used to put chairs, and the people sit down to listen to the speeches of Fidel Castro. So the Pope, John Paul II, when he visited Cuba in 1998, he gave the last mass here, up here, because it's a big place where a lot of people can be there. So you want to make a picture?
Yeah.
Sí, no sabía, ¿me la aprendiste? About
5 horas abierto, ¿eh? All kind of rum and Cuba made from sugar cane. Using a sugar cane as raw material. Here to the right side is a bus station. The bus station, but the national one from here. We have the buses going for the rest of the country. Santiago de Cuba, and Rio, and Panama. Well, that's the name of that street is Carlos the Third. Carlos the Third, he was the king of Spain when the English took Havana in 1762. Well, here the market Carlos the Third. In that building here to your left, coming up here, is a Ministry of Mines, Energy and Mines. The building here to your left is the National Cuban Association of Freemasons. The Freemason in Cuba up here. In front, a nice building in restoration now is the Church of the Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Con los jefes, pero no tuviera que vender más, porque ya inventé excursiones nuevas para que vengan más con el museo. Digo, lo cogí.
My friend, it's interesting here, but we're gonna be here later on. We're gonna visit here. This is the part of a Brotherhood of America. In the middle of the park, you see the tree with the metallic bars all around. You see that tree is a tree of a Brotherhood of America. The tree have been planted with a little bit of soil from all the countries of America. What?
Por aquí estaba llegando el tren, no había quien pasara por ahí. Motorina, bicicleta, visita, sí, camioneta, camión.
Well, you see some of the first machines introducing Cuban history. Cuba have been the country number 6 having the train in the world. We had the train in 1837. 11 years before Spain, and that's very curious because it was Spain who introduced the train in Cuba. They made it 11 years before they had it in Spain. Here, all those machines have the name of a sugar mill they were working for, right? And here, the train station. From the colonial time, is still the train station in this moment. Well, look here to the right side, top wall. Look at this big and thick wall. It's part of the remainder. Of the former tree, the big walls that the government of Spain made in 17th century to protect the city. You know, the whole city of Havana, had these big and thick walls all around the city. With about 10 gates. The gates have been opened every morning at 4 o'clock and closed every evening at 9 o'clock. But they announced the opening or the closing of doors or walls, shooting a cannon. Bang! So you could hear. To put down the bridges and open the gates so the people could get in and out. Then, at 9 in the evening for the second time, bang! And they closed the gates and lifted the bridges. It was almost impossible to be able to attack the city, but to pass over the wall and over the moat. And it was like this for 2 centuries. What happened? In one moment, in 19th century, the city of Havana was bigger out of the walls than inside the walls. Here, ladies policemen, oh my God, they're really hot. Yeah, with a man you can talk, yeah, maybe, okay, next time I'm gonna give you a ticket. But the ladies, no way, don't argue with them.
This ain't a white
people. I can see that, right? But you know what? It's always uncomplicated, man. Then they make sign up to take my class. And my mistake, I didn't take a little class. I didn't know how it was in Russian. I brought the class I had for beer, you know, big glass. And they fill up my glass. It was too much, more than half bottle. And then I said, well, I've got a class for the whole evening, you know. Oh no, they were angry. Red. Hey, I didn't understand what they were talking about, but I could see they were angry. And then somebody told me, Eric, they're very angry with you. You're supposed to make empty your glass. And he said, how come? It's too much. Impossible. I waited for the whole evening. No. Okay, finish of the history. I took the whole glass. And I was telling them, please,
I have to make a show tonight, a night show. If I drink this, I cannot work. No, no, they didn't understand. So I took my dress when I was going away. This is the park I told you this morning of a Brotherhood of America. You see, the tree of a Brotherhood with the bars. The other park. And here, all around the park, you have a poster. Those posters are the main heroes of America. Lincoln, San Martin, Sandino, Juarez, Bolívar, Sucre, Hidalgo, Martín, Miranda, Tiradentes. Some of the main heroes of the whole continent. Brazil, Argentina, Uruguay, Mexico, Cuba, even United States. They are all there in that park. But we're going to come back here. Well, my friend, you can see that street. The name is Reina, Queen. Too bad. Beautiful colonial building. They have been beautiful long time ago. But waiting for the restoration. Really too bad. Some of them are falling down. We lost some of them. We lost some after hurricane or raining too much. Some of them have fallen down. So, but the Havana is too big. And we cannot, it's not allowed, demolish and make again. It's much easier, demolish and make a new one. But here, they want to conserve the history, the original architecture. And that takes a lot of money that we don't have in Cuba. Some world organization that are helping us in that from Italy, and then the government is making what they can try to save those old buildings. It's good, the part of Havana we have visited this morning, everything has been restored in that part. It's the oldest one, but it's too much. So we won't make it in time. I'm gonna take my cigar for this weekend. Every time I visit here, they give me one cigar. Well. Here again, the tree of a Brotherhood of America. You can see the bars around the tree. The post of the main heroes of America. Look, to your left is the beginning of a Chinatown. If you can read the Chinese letters, you can read the Chinatown, the parliament. But after the Cuban Revolution, it became just a museum of the parliament. But now, after the restoration that took place about a couple of years ago, it's been again
the parliament. There was a theater in the first half of 20th century. It's going to be restored, the building. They're going to try to save it again. In Deza, the most beautiful building here in Havana. There's a grand theater of Havana, my friends. Grand theater from 1837. It was compared with La Scala from Milan, opera from Paris, and you may see from London, among the most famous theater of the world in the mid of 19th century. Now is the seat of the National Cuban Ballet in the National Opera. Every year they organize the International Festival of Classic Ballet of Havana here. Coming to Havana, some of the most important companies of ballet in the world. So we're gonna let you in the Central Park, and you can take a little walk until Capitol Building if you wanna make a picture of it. In front of the nice building here in front is a Museum of Fine Arts, but Universal Fine Arts. There is the Hall of France, the Hall of Germany, Italy, and many other countries. You can see the front of this beautiful building, the Grand Theater of Havana. Yeah, we're gonna go out here. This is the oldest hotel of Cuba, Hotel Inglaterra from 1874. It's a four-star hotel even now. And then the monument of Jose Marti again, the national Cuban hero. In 28 palm trees around him. Why 28 palms? A palm tree is the royal palm, is a national Cuban tree. In 28 because Martí was born on January the 28th. In honor to his birthday day, they planted 28 palms. In 1906, when they made this.
Dzisiaj 20 marca 2024. Jestem w Hawanie, tak, w centrum stolicy. Tak. I pozdrawiam wszystkich, którzy będą oglądać.
My friend.